Hello everyone, welcome to Greypot. In Kerala cuisine, the crispy pappadams hold a special place. Whether in a traditional sadhya or the favorite breakfast puttu. However, it has recently become one of the most adulterated foods. It is simple to make these excellent pappadams at home without any hazardous ingredients. So check out the simple Kerala pappadams, and I'm gonna make this during this Onam Sadhya. And to make these pappadams, the main ingredient is urad dal. So take 1 cup urad dal, add that into a blender and blend it to a very fine powder. Then sift it. Sift it 2 to 3 times and finally sift it through a very fine sieve to get rid of all the big particles. Then into that add in baking soda, salt and mix it. Then add some room temperature water little by little and make that into a dough. Once everything comes together to a dough, add some sesame oil and knead it. When you knead the dough, you can feel the dough has become really firm. Using a pestle, pound the firm dough on a clean countertop for approximately 20 minutes, folding and flattening it as you go. This is the very important step in this recipe. You should fold the dough, beat it and flatten it for almost 20 minutes. Then lately you can see the hard dough should have softened and become pliable, similar to a chapati dough. Make a long log out of this dough and cut out small pieces from it. Now to roll out this dough, sprinkle some all-purpose flour on the countertop and start rolling out each pieces. You have to roll this into very thin sheets. And as I'm rolling out the dough, you can see it's not sticking to the board or onto the rolling pin. It's because we have kneaded the dough really well. You won't need to add any more flour for rolling once the dough has been kneaded correctly. Even when rolling, don't attempt to produce a perfect round form because we can always use a bowl to cut out a perfect round. As you can see, I have rolled it out into a very thin sheet. Now take that onto a tray and make all the round shapes like this. Now using a bowl, cut out the perfect round shape and place it onto a tray for drying. Traditionally, the papadam makers dry this under the sun, but you just have to dry this on room temperature for around 5 to 10 minutes. And then our papadams are ready for frying. You can even store this in an airtight container and whenever you need the fresh fried papadams, take one or two and fry it in oil. Now for frying, heat some oil and once the oil gets heated up, put each papadams in oil and look at that, how beautifully it got puffed up. Just flip it and cook for 2 to 3 seconds. Once it gets nicely fried, take it out. Try frying all the papadums in the same way, and it's impossible to define the emotion you get as you see them puff one by one. The major problem we encounter after pounding and rolling these papadums is drying them. But all you have to do is now dry it at room temperature for 5 to 10 minutes and it'll be ready for frying. We can store these dry papadums in an airtight container and store it in refrigerator. I hope you give it a try because it's so worth it. You'll forget about all those hard works and pains when you see these papadums get puffed up while frying. I couldn't think of a finer dish to share with you all now that Onam is just around the corner. So definitely try this crispy and tasty papadums to serve with your Onam Sadhya. So hope you enjoy the recipe. Leave your valuable comments and suggestions in the comment section below. Follow us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and Pinterest. Click the logo to subscribe to Greypot and watch more interesting recipes from our channel. Thank you.